संजय अग्रवाल. संजय अग्रवाल, I'm trying to look at it from not from the government perspective, from the consumer perspective. You can just unmute your mic for us, sir. If you're going to buy a product, let's say you're buying a laptop, you're looking at a brand and you're looking at specs and you're looking at price. Now, within that laptop, maybe a chip, maybe all the chips, maybe the screen is made in China. You don't know. So how do I, as a consumer who doesn't want to buy conscious, buy Chinese, know the difference?
You see, I think you have suggested a slew of measures. There is a ton of them, and I think most of them address how to make sure that one doesn't end up buying a Chinese product. So, in fact, I would be repeating your views if I, try to answer this particular question. But let me just confirm one particular move that you have recommended, which is to lay the foundation of first silicon chip manufacturing plant within 100 days.
Here.
I strongly endorse it. Our PhD chamber has been, I think, recommending this for the last 1 year. In each and every recommendation that we send to the government, we have been talking about it. And let me tell you, this chip manufacturing facility cannot be set up by a private sector. The government has been inviting people for the last 2-3 years, or rather 5 years. And people have come up and they have backed out because of the size of investment. But if you look at the volume of imports that is coming into the country, simply because we lack the chip manufacturing capability, I think that alone would justify it. Our recommendation is that a large public sector undertaking in the electronics field, like Bharat Electronics or ITI even, or somebody, could be asked to buy the technology and set up a chip manufacturing plant, and thereby create a complete ecosystem on which you create the electronic items, integrated circuits, all the parts that go into making of manufacturing of electronic products. The single largest group of items that India is importing from China, it's worth $12 billion currently every year, and that is all electronics / telecom or to some extent solar panels.
Correct.
So if we spend $2 to $3 billion into a chip manufacturing facility, and we start with a policy, let us buy technology and not buy products. That is the motto that we are
putting forward. Bang on. Absolutely right.
Let us buy technology. If we don't have it, let's buy it. Similarly, on telecom, on 4G, 5G front, 5G is a bit of a way off. It's still a technology in development. 4G at the same time has lost its sheen. The technology would be available at very reasonable prices. Again, something like CDOT or CDAC or some central government PSU should buy the technology again for 4G and license it out to not just one or two, maybe 5, 10, 20, just like the CDOT model of earlier.
And let's set up a 2,000 crore fund to start developing 5G today. Let's not wait 10 years later for again Huawei to come and ask us to upgrade to 5G or sorry 6G on Mount Everest.
Let them do that. You see, point is we need the basic bread and butter first. And let me tell you, we are spending 50,000 crores on encouraging the manufacturing of mobile phones in India. That is called the PLI scheme. Now, against that, if we can spare that sort of funds, we can definitely spare 15,000-20,000 crores to set up the chip manufacturing and at the same time, the 4G technology.
Exactly. So we are one of the biggest mobile phone manufacturers in the world, but we are manufacturing for Chinese-owned brands. We are not developing an Indian-owned brand. And that teaches you a very, very valuable lesson. Just stay with me. General Dhruv Kotoch, I want you to inject an important